You see, I never had to call myself the best in the world. Other people said it for me. These people said it for me. And I never had to write it on the back of a t-shirt. They would write it on signs and bring it to the arena. And the reason for that is this. I am part of a special breed of performers. I am one of a literal dying breed of performers that toured the world, honing our craft, learning our skills, becoming stars before we ever got to the WWE. A breed of performers that were given nothing and took everything. And yeah, I developed a chip on my shoulder because of it. And now, punk, you're just like me. You're a maverick, a rebel that went against the grain and became something more than anybody thought that you would. You're a Chris Jericho wannabe, just like all of them are Chris Jericho wannabes. And it's so obviously, oh yeah, you know it's true. And okay. It's so obviously blatant by the fact you plagiarize me every step of the way.
Just stop.
Don't you tell me to stop, boy. I'm talking to you.
And I'm listening, but I think everybody else is sick of listening. So I'm gonna go ahead. Look, Chris, I know how good you are. These people know how good you are. My problem I have with you is you coming out here and insinuating that I've stolen anything from you. No, I've never plagiarized anything in my life. Everything I have, I've fought for and I've earned. It's right here. You think you invented saying that you were the best? Are you kidding me? Hey, there's a guy I remember watching when I was a kid. You probably watched him when you were a kid too. His name's Bret Hitman Hart. The best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. Did you invent that? Did you give that to him when you were, what, 2 years old? Huh? He's Canadian, too. Did you invent him being Canadian?
I have faced every legend, every Hall of Fame, future Hall of Fame performer in this ring and beaten them all. I've won dozens of championships. I've had dozens of classic matches, classic WrestleMania Steal the Show matches, dozens of moments that will be legendary long after either one of us are gone.
You know, you keep saying that, and your words just scream superiority, but I watch you and the way you walk out here and the inflection in your voice, and certainly your body language, it screams inferiority. Who are you trying to prove? You're trying to prove to me that you're the best? Are you trying to prove to these people that you're the best? Or are you trying to prove to yourself that you're the best? See, I say I'm the best in the world, and yeah, that's a little cocky, but confidence is nothing that I've ever lacked, and it's nothing I thought you lacked. But now that confidence, Chris, it seems to be replaced with jealousy. See, you look at me and you see a guy that emerged from the same shadows you did. He came from the same places you did. He overcame the same obstacles you did. But now, he surpassed everything that you did, didn't he? Because sure, you beat legends. You beat the Stone Cold, and you beat Rock on the same night 10 years ago, and that made you the WWE champion. But you were never really the man like how I'm the man, were you? And that just bothers you a little bit, doesn't it? You have a Napoleon complex because of it. So you come back and you try to point fingers and place the blame. The blame's only on you. See, you say that you're the best in the world at what you do, and I say that I'm the best wrestler in the world. This is nothing I chose. I was born this way. This is who I am. This is what I do. While you choose to leave and write books and have a radio show and be on game shows, and you choose to be a rock star. And all the while, I'm here on top, swimming with sharks, while you're dancing with stars.
When I was dancing with stars, punk, and killing it on The Tonight Show and becoming a bigger star than you ever were, all I can think of was one thing, and that was you ripping me off. Every single night, you ripping me off, punk. And let me be completely clear and honest with you. All of those January 2nd vignettes and the best in the world verbiage and this light up flashy fancy jacket, it's all window dressing because I came back to the WWE for one reason and one reason only. And that was to embarrass you on the biggest stage in the world. To take back what is mine, to beat you for that world title at WrestleMania and shove down your throat that I am the best in the world at what I do. I prove it, I claim it, I am it every single night.
That's all you had to say. When you came back, you didn't have to jump me to get my attention. All you had to do was grab me and say, hey, punk, me and you. Best in the world versus best in the world at WrestleMania. See, this is the time of year everybody points at that sign, but I'm going to point at my championship title. Because to me, I don't need Chris Brown and you don't need Mickey Rourke. And we don't need all the pyro in the world or inflatable letters to tell everybody how awesome we are. And I don't need a fancy entrance. And screw your stupid light bright jacket. The only thing we need is me and you in a ring. And on April 1st, we're gonna find out exactly who the best in the world is, because to me, those are the only ingredients we need in the recipe to have what quite possibly could be the greatest wrestling match in WrestleMania history. But, see, I have something you covet, and I say come and get it. And at the end of the night, when you're looking over your shoulder on the ramp and you see this, it's not going to be the end of the world. It's just going to be the end of yours.